Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 88 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 152 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 153 and question number 154. Question 153. You have an Azure subscription that contains a storage account named Storage 1. The Storage 1 account contains a container named Container 1. You need to create a lifecycle management rule for Storage 1 that will automatically be move the blobs in Container 1 to lowest cost tier after 90 days. How should you complete the rule? And these rules are defined in lifecycle management policy. And Azure Storage Lifecycle Management offers a rule-based policy that you can use to transition blob data to appropriate access tiers or to expire data at the end of the data lifecycle. In the given rule, we need to select that after 90 days, which access tier the data should be moved in and what filter to be used to select the data of container 1. So first of all, about the blob data access tiers, we do have hot access tier, which is used for frequently accessed data. We do have cool access tier, which is used for infrequently accessed data, and generally the data in the cool tier should be stored for minimum 30 days. Third one is cold access tier, which is again used for infrequently accessed data, and generally data is stored for minimum 90 days of period. And next one is archived access tier, which is an offline tier optimized to store data that is rarely accessed and should be stored for minimum of 180 days. The data storage cost is higher on hotter side and it's lower in the archive side. Therefore, the data should be automatically moved to blob in container 1 to archive tier after 90 days. Tier 2 archive is the correct answer. And next question is, which filter we should use to filter out the container 1 data? So we should use the prefix match to filter out the container 1, and it would be the container 1. Let's move to next question. Question 154. You have an Azure subscription. The subscription contains a storage account named Storage 1 that has the lifecycle management rules shown in the following table. Rule 1. If base blob were last modified more than 5 days, then rule 1 will trigger and it will move to cool storage. Rule 2 will trigger after the 5 days of modification and it will delete the blob. And rule 3 will trigger after the 5 days and it will move to archive storage. On June 1st, you store a blob named file 1 in the hot access tier of storage 1. What is the state of file 1 on June 7? Now if you have noticed this, that all the rules are triggering on 5th day, so same condition and different actions. Therefore we need to understand that which rule will trigger and which rule will be overridden. To understand it better, let's go to learn.microsoft.com. We are on learn.microsoft.com site, and at the optimize cost by automatically managing the data lifecycle page, we'll scroll down. Note, if you define more than one action On the same blob, lifecycle management applies the least expensive action to the blob. Therefore, if we do have 3 or 4 action triggering on the same day, it will go for the least expensive action. For example, action delete is the cheaper than the action tier to archive. Action tier to archive is cheaper than action tier to cool. Therefore, delete action is the cheapest one. Let's go back to question. Therefore, highest expensive action to the blob would be option C, which is the highest to in hot access tier. The second highest would be store in cool access tier. The third highest would be that we can store the data in archive access tier. And the least expensive action would be that we can delete the data. Therefore, option D is the correct answer. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.